We are in Bedford, and we are in my favorite place in the house, one of my favorite places in the house, which is my bathroom. It's our bathroom, David and my bathroom, but I spend a lot of time in here. I really love when the fireplace is lit in our bedroom, and I hear the crackling, and I light candles, and I have a great book, and I run a really amazing bath with a you know, I'd like to switch it up. I use the Herbivore Coconut Milk Bath Soak. Sometimes if I'm sore and I've been exercising a lot, I'll use the Naturopathica Bath Flakes. It's sweet birch magnesium, so it's very calming for the nighttime. And I feel like throughout my years of travel, whenever you have jet lag, having a hot bath, it really has been a tremendous help, and I find it's like quite profound, the difference. I love this Folane lavender bath salt. It's really smells amazing, and it's so nice in the bath, and your skin feels so tight and clean afterward. Sometimes I'll do a mask in the bath at the same time. I like to do a little dry scrub before I get in the bath. And I bought this, to be honest, because I thought it looked so cool. At Cap Beauty, I was like, what is that? I didn't even care what it was. This brand, Subtle Energies, is so lovely that my friend Catherine turned me on to. It's Australian, and they have these relaxing, stress, anxiety-relieving patches. Because my hair gets really red if I use anything that will strip the ashiness out of my hair. So I tend to... If I'm going to get my roots done the next day, I will do a hair mask. Once in Japan, I remember asking all of these journalists what their trick was. Why did they look so youthful and healthy and glowing? And they said all the Japanese women take baths, like really long baths. They don't run an extremely hot bath, but they stay in it for 45 minutes. And it gets your blood rate and your heart up, your heart rate and your blood flowing, so it's as if you've exercised for an hour. And I love this exfoliating towel. It's Tenfold, that brand Tenfold. And I tend to, sometimes I'll use an exfoliating balm and I'll massage my face in the bath. And then I'll use a mask and then I'll massage the two together, my neck, my chest. Sometimes in the winter I like to have with my book, I like to have a glass of red wine with a fire, and it's super relaxing. And then in the summer, sometimes I'll have a really refreshing cup of tea. My children, my old agent, Leslie Sweeney at Art and Commerce, I remember when I had my first child 12 years ago and he got his first cold, I remember she said, oh, do you use Dr. Singha mustard bath? And I said, no, what is that? And she said, oh, it just pulls out the cold. It's the most incredible thing. So ever since Leslie told me that, this is a staple in every house, Dr. Singha mustard seed bath, mustard powder. And I use a scoop of this in all three children's bath every single night. And if you have sore muscles, if you feel like you're achy, if you have a bit of a cold, this is magic. I get it from the health food store online. Whole Foods has it. Eminence is another one of my favorites. This is a strawberry rhubarb dermifoliant. It's a nice, gentle lactic acid exfoliator. So you pour it in your hand and add a little bit of water and gently exfoliate. And my shower gel is the Dr. Hauschka lavender sandalwood. I alternate between this one and a lemon verbena. This gold fadden, it's a really nice scrub. I'm obsessed with scrubs. Super gentle, super clean. This herbivore coconut is so divine. It's great for a summer bath. Oh, it's so nice and light and just mild. The smell and your skin feels really kind of clean and hydrated at the same time. I don't love feeling super dry after a bath. Maybe we should try to do an exfoliating balm together. If you guys, I would love to hear any feedback you have, any bath essentials that you think I should try in my comments, please let me know. And if you like any of these products, share. I'd love to hear. And thanks for watching.